There have been some significant updates to LaunchAir 12.1 and it is getting better with each update. Now, it is important to mention, and I also feel that it is a long way behind LaunchAir 2 when it comes to overall customization. And I also hope that LaunchAir 12.1 comes to Google Play Store, because many users either don't know about it or they just don't want to use any applications outside Google Play Store. With that said, let's see what the latest version of LaunchAir Launcher brings to the table. One of the most important features that came with Android 12 was Material U theming, and it got a bit better with Android 13. LaunchAir Launcher started implementing Material U theming as well, and it is also getting better with each update. Now, apart from choosing the system or the wallpaper color, you can pick colors from HSB or RGB models, and this is an amazing feature. Another interesting feature that came with Android 12 or Android 13 is the themed icons. Well, LaunchAir has a separate application for that, and they call it Lawn Icons. With over 700 icons, it gives you a great coverage, and moreover, you can select themed icons for home screen, application drawer, or both of them. LaunchAir also gives you an option of transparent background for these themed icons, which is a great feature related to customization. Now, if you talk about icon shapes, the latest version of LaunchAir Launcher gives you some really good options. Apart from selecting the shapes from the already provided category, you can change the corner shapes as per your preference. You also get an option to reset the custom icons, and I think this is a very handy feature if you are changing your icon packs every now and then. Talking about icon packs, there is one single icon pack that I always use with LaunchAir, and that is PixMaterial U. It is one of my favorite icon packs available on Google Play Store because it is an adaptive icon pack and it changes color based on the wallpaper you use. I know there are other adaptive icon packs based on Material U, but nothing comes close to PixMaterial U. I will leave a link to this icon pack as well as other adaptive icon packs in the video description in case you want to check them out. Now, let's go ahead and move to the next feature, that is gestures. Gestures are very important when it comes to third-party launchers. In the previous version of LaunchAir Launcher, there was double tap to sleep, but the latest version gives you double tap to open notification panel, open application drawer, or application search. If you ask me, I never use double tap to sleep, but it can be a very handy feature for many users. I always use double tap to open that home screen pop-up menu, but that feature is not available in LaunchAir right now, and I hope it gets added in the upcoming updates. Apart from the double tap feature, there is this separate section for gestures like swipe up and down or home and back button gestures, which can be really helpful to make things easier. And please note that double tap to sleep requires accessibility permission to work, so if you are okay with that, then it can be a very handy feature for sure. The latest version of LaunchAir Launcher also gives you more control over widgets. Now you will be able to use rounded corners for widgets, and there is also an option for widget overlap, which can be really helpful in taking your home screen customization to next level. The latest version of LaunchAir Launcher also comes with some additional search providers. As you guys know that Google Search is the default option for most Android devices out there, and if you don't want to use that or if you are using any Android phone without Google, well, the recent version of LaunchAir Launcher gives you a great list of search providers for home screen dock like DuckDuckGo, Presearch, Brave, or GitHub. And talking about application drawer, there have been some minor improvements in the application drawer search bar. Now, you have an option to enable or disable the hidden applications from search results. You can also choose the number of applications that appear in the search result count. Other settings are more or less similar to the previous version of LaunchAir. The latest version of LaunchAir Launcher also comes with some really good folder customization. If you prefer having a bunch of folders on your home screen, LaunchAir 12.1 has incorporated Material U into folders as well. Now, apart from changing the columns, rows, and background transparency, you can choose different background colors from different presets or use the same RGB and HSB models. The latest version of LaunchAir Launcher also comes with Quick Switch. If you guys have heard about Quick Switch, it can help you customize the Recents menu in rooted devices. Well, the latest version of LaunchAir Launcher supports Quick Switch, and you can add options like Screenshot, Google Lens, and Clear All to the Recents menu. I could not test this feature because I am still planning to root my phone, but I think Quick Switch should work fine with LaunchAir 12.1. Now, if you talk about experimental features, there have been some really good additions here as well. Now you have more options to customize at a glance, and you can also increase home screen grid size to 20x20 if you prefer that extensive kind of home screen customization. I also wanted to let you know that if you are using the debug version of LaunchAir 12.1, you will get this permanent banner in the launcher settings, which talks about this version can be unstable or might have some bugs and all. But I think it has been working fine so far, so yeah, you can use it aramse. And if you are wondering where these wallpapers are from, there are two applications I normally use to get all these awesome wallpapers. One is WallFactory and the second one is All-in-One Wallpapers. And unfortunately, these applications are not free. They are premium wallpaper applications, and if you want to try any of them, I'll place the links in the video description. I also wanted to let you know that if you are using a Xiaomi device, these navigation gestures are not going to work with third-party launchers like LaunchAir or any other launcher available out there. I know that there are different solutions available out there, but they don't work that fine. So if you are planning to use navigation gestures with third-party launchers, you have to either root your phone or you can also use a custom ROM instead. And that was all about today's video. Let me know your thoughts about the latest version of LaunchAir launcher in the comment section below. And if you enjoyed this video, please make sure you hit the subscribe button and turn on channel notifications so that you get notified whenever I post a new video. Thank you so much for watching. I'll see you in the next one.